Now, what do Shenzhen and Hong Kong's innovation systems look like? As a reminder, an innovation system is a structure of institutional relationships that companies use in order to turn ideas into profits. The components of these innovation systems often include universities, research centers, of course, companies, maybe government-sponsored entities, and even startup companies. And existing studies show that Shenzhen's university-industrial linkages remain relatively fragmented. The infographic we look at now shows the clusters or the groupings of companies that work together on innovation-related projects, shows groupings or clusters of companies and universities or research centers that work together on innovative projects. The lower part of this infographic shows the qualitative nature of each of these clusters. For example, dyadic relationships characterize a relatively large percent of these clusters, dyadic meaning two members of the group. Shenzhen's innovation system has relatively few bridgers and relatively few clusters that involve a wide number of entities. Whereas in the largest proportion of these agglomerations center around a key actor. Looking at the results from this clustering, we see that such innovative performance has benefited from cooperation across the business-university divide. Thus, such cooperation has promoted innovative interactions, has promoted these companies' own innovation, yet has come at the expense of intergroup training and training from customers. Interestingly, though unsurprisingly, the amount of education Shenzhen companies' employees have has no appreciable impact on the innovative performance of these companies. And as we saw previously, innovative clustering appears to happen much less in Shenzhen than this hub-and-spoke system centered around one central player within a particular cluster. Figure 12 from our study reviews the way that Chinese companies file for U.S. patents. And what we see is that both in terms of applying for US patents and China patents, we see that the majority of these patent holders represent large consolidated industrial complexes. On the US patent side, we see companies like Huawei, Fujian Sinopec, whereas in on the China patent side, again we see Huawei, ZTE, and again Sinopec, suggesting that it's the same large industrial groups that are filing for patents in these various jurisdictions. Thus, despite all the media attention on Shenzhen as a center for entrepreneurship, these data suggest that much of the innovation in the region remains centered on large industrial groups. Thus, the message from this group of infographics appears that large enterprises dominate the innovation scene and that other players remain relatively atomistic, and universities play a role in promoting innovation, but their contribution to Shenzhen's innovation system remains exceedingly weak. For the weakness of Qianhai's universities, other evidence suggests that cooperation with Hong Kong's universities could well increase the performance of these innovative endeavors. Fu and Li run regressions trying to explain novel innovation and the diffusion of innovation in the region. And what they find is that Shenzhen companies' cooperation with Hong Kong, Taiwan, Singapore, or Korean universities leads to a significant bump in novel innovation. Cooperation with other organizations leads to a much less pronounced increase in such innovation, and the returns to both internal R&D and external R&D remain relatively mitigated. Yet other data appear to contradict these trends. Huang and Sharif for their study show that R&D intensity does indeed have a significant impact on industrial growth, that horizontal spillovers of capital from Hong Kong do indeed affect such industrial growth in Shenzhen, as do spillovers of other types of foreign capital, yet cooperation with Hong Kong companies does not appear to influence industrial growth, except perhaps to reduce such growth. Thus, the picture emerging from these studies appears to be that Hong Kong's universities and thinking institutions tend to produce marketable, profitable innovations in Shenzhen, but cooperating with Hong Kong's own innovative companies does not.